তো অ্যাকচুয়ালি উই স্টাডি টুডে দ্য স্মুদিং টেকনিক অ্যান্ড ফোরকাস্টিং অন দ্য বেসিস অফ সাম ডিটারমিনিস্টিক মডেল অফ টাইম সিরিজ, রাইট? ডু হ্যাভ এনি আইডিয়া অ্যাবাউট দ্য টাইম সিরিজ মডেলিং? এনিবডি ফ্রম দ্য পার্টিসিপেন্টস? চন্দন দাস?
স্যার স্যার বেসিক্যালি ওই ডিটারমাইন অন দ্য বেসিস অফ দ্য টাইম প্রোগ্রেস অর ডিক্রিজ অফ দ্য প্রোডাকশন অর সামথিং।
ওকে, দ্যাট ইজ বেসড অন দ্য পাস্ট ভ্যালুজ অফ দ্য ভেরিয়েবল, ইউ ট্রাই টু প্রেডিক্ট দ্য ফিউচার ভ্যালুজ অফ দ্য ভেরিয়েবল, রাইট?
ইয়েস স্যার।
ওকে, এনিথিং এলস? নো,
প্লিজ রেসপন্ড।
অ্যাকচুয়ালি হ্যাঁ ওকে, নো প্রবলেম। সো টাইম সিরিজ মডেলিং অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইজ বেসড অন টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা। ডু ইউ হ্যাভ এন আইডিয়া অ্যাবাউট দ্য টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা, দীপ্তি? হ্যালো,
নো স্যার,
নো স্যার, নো আইডিয়া।
নো আইডিয়া? ওকে ওকে, সো ডু হ্যাভ এন আইডিয়া অ্যাবাউট দ্য ক্রস সেকশন ডেটা? নো।
ইয়েস
সো
স্যার।
নো,
ফর এম্পিরিক্যাল রিসার্চ ইউ হ্যাভ টু হ্যান্ডেল ডেটা, রাইট? অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ টু অ্যারেঞ্জ দ্য ডেটা সেট দ্যাট ইউ হ্যাভ কালেক্টেড। সো ডেটা ইজ দ্য জাস্ট ইনফরমেশন দ্যাট ইউ কালেক্ট ফর স্টাডি, ফর অ্যানালিসিস, রাইট? সো বেসিক্যালি টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা, হোয়েন ইউ কালেক্ট ডেটা ফর এ পার্টিকুলার অবজেক্ট ওভার টাইম, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা। সো ইফ ইউ লুক অ্যাট দ্য সেন্সেক্স, রাইট, সো ইউ উইল গেট ডেটা এভরি পয়েন্ট অফ টাইম। ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট ডেটা, ডেলি ডেটা, কালেক্ট ডেলি ডেটা ফর সেন্সেক্স, ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট মান্থলি ডেটা, ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট আওয়ারলি ডেটা, এটসেট্রা এটসেট্রা। সো হোয়েন দ্য ডেটা হ্যাজ সাম টাইম ডাইমেনশন, দেন ইট ইজ কল্ড টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা। লাইক ইউ আর সেইং দ্য ডেটা অফ কমোডিটি সেলিং অর পারচেজিং, রাইট? রেভিনিউ ডেটা, কস্ট, এভরিথিং। ইফ ইউর ডেটা হ্যাজ সাম টাইম ডাইমেনশন, দেন ইট ইজ কল্ড টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা। সাপোজ ইফ ইউ কালেক্ট ডেটা দ্য ডেলি সেল অফ অ্যামাজন, রাইট, দেন ইউ গেট ডিফারেন্ট পয়েন্ট ইন টার্মস অফ মানি অর ইন টার্মস অফ নাম্বার অফ ডেলিভারি এটসেট্রা এটসেট্রা ওভার টাইম, পার ডে, পার উইক, পার মান্থ, এটসেট্রা এটসেট্রা। ইফ ইউ কনসিডার দ্য ডেটা ফর দ্য প্রাইস অফ স্টক ফর এনি কোম্পানি লাইক ইনফোসিস, সো ইউ উইল গেট প্রাইস অফ দেয়ার শেয়ার এভরি ডে, রাইট? ইফ ইউ কনসিডার দ্য ম্যাক্রো ইকোনমিক ডেটা, ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট ডেটা ফর জিডিপি এভরি কোয়ার্টার, রাইট? ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট ডেটা ফর সেভিংস, ইউ ক্যান কালেক্ট ডেটা ফর ইনভেস্টমেন্ট, ক্যাপিটাল অ্যাকুমুলেশন, এটসেট্রা এটসেট্রা, রেট অফ ইন্টারেস্ট পার কোয়ার্টার, এটসেট্রা এটসেট্রা। সো হোয়েন দ্য ডেটা সেট হ্যাজ সাম টাইম ডাইমেনশন, দেন ইট ইজ কল্ড টাইম সিরিজ ডেটা। সে ইট ইজ ডিনোটেড বাই ওয়াইটি, ওয়াইটি মিন্স ভ্যালু অফ ওয়াই ভেরিয়েবল, সে জিডিপি, অ্যান্ড টি ফর টাইম। টাইম মে বি কন্টিনিউয়াস, মে বি ডিসক্রিট, ওকে? ইফ ইট ইজ ডিসক্রিট, দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু কালেক্ট ডেটা ফর ফলোয়িং এ গিভেন ইন্টারভেল। সো ইফ ইউ কালেক্ট ডেটা এভরি ফার্স্ট ডে অফ মান্থ, দেন অর লাস্ট ডে অফ দ্য মান্থ, দেন ডেটা, ইয়েস
স্যার, বোর্ডটা দেখতে পাচ্ছি না ক্লিয়ারলি, দেখতেই পাচ্ছি না।
ক্যান ইউ হিয়ার মি?
ইয়েস, শুনতে পাচ্ছি স্যার, কান্ট হিয়ার দ্য বোর্ড।
দেন ইজ ওকে, নো প্রবলেম। ओके सो इफ द डेटा हैज सम टाइम डायमेंशन देन इट इज कॉल्ड टाइम सीरीज डेटा इफ यू कलेक्ट डेटा पर मंथ पर डे पर आवर पर सेकेंड देन इट इज कॉल्ड टाइम सीरीज डेटा सो व्हाई डू यू कलेक्ट डेटा टू अंडरस्टैंड द past behavior of the variable past behavior of the variable suppose if you collect the data per month if you collect data for 2 years per month for census then you can analyze the nature of ups and downs of the census okay so from the historical data or the past values of the variable over time we try to gauge the future values of the variable that is we want to forecast the future values of the variable so time series modeling are of basically two types one is the univariate time series analysis and another is the multivariate time series analysis for forecasting you should consider the all related variables to forecast the future values of a particular series so when time series data is collected it is called time series okay for example if you want to forecast the future value of our GDP for the next quarter then you should analyze the past values of the GDP and not only that you should consider the past values of investment past values of consumption etc etc So these are the related variables, right? Then you basically formulate a regression model to understand the future values of the variable. But in case of time series data, it is very difficult to apply the conventional regression model because in time series modeling, if you consider a very simple model, suppose YT is your GDP and XT is your investment then if you formulate a simple linear regression model like alpha plus beta xt plus ut then here from here you have to know the series of xt and yt but actually they are the estimated values gdps are not the actual value they are the estimated values that is why they are stochastic in nature that is they are random in nature right so then if you formulate this kind of modeling you have to understand what is the nature of the series in terms of their past values basically to include the other variables for forecasting you have to know many variables know the behavior of many variables and if you want to find out the impact of any policy on the future values and current values and future values of the variable then you have to know the policy variables and other variables so it is very much difficult actually in modern econometrics we study this kind of modeling where we consider the randomness nature of the relationship or randomness nature of the data set we do not go to this part we only consider the deterministic model where we do not consider the stochastic relationship among the variables right so we confine only the non stochastic modeling of time series and secondly we do not consider the second variable for analysis so therefore in this introductory class we basically study the single variable that is we study the historical behavior of a single variable and on the basis of the past behavior of the variable we try to predict the future values of the variable this is the main objective of this class so here we consider the deterministic model where we do not consider the randomness that is stochastic feature of the time series data we do not consider it And second point is we do not consider more variables. We consider only one variable. That is, we try to predict the future value of census based on the past values of the sensex, not on other values. You know that sensex is falling now due to the spread of the coronavirus in other countries. So we do not consider this kind of other factors. Here we predict the future values of sensex based on the past values of sensex. So it is a very simple model. And here we consider the deterministic model. In that sense, we consider only the non-random nature of the time series, right? So here, that is why we are confined here the univariate time series analysis, right? Univariate time series analysis. That is, we considered the only one series for forecasting the future values of the series based on the past values of the series. Just a minute, sorry. So, and secondly, we considered the very simple analysis, that is smoothing and forecasting. Forecasting means the prediction of the future values, and smoothing means the just smooth out the different fluctuations in the time series. So in any time series data, YT has generally four parts. One is the secular trend, another is cyclical fluctuation, T. Third is seasonal variation, and purely random part, that is irregular component, right? If you write YT in the product form, then it is called multiplicative model of time series. So any time series component, any time series observation has generally four part. If it is a yearly data, then seasonal part is absent. There is no seasonal variation. If the data set is monthly or quarterly, then there is a seasonal part, that is seasonal variation. Suppose sale of winter cloth, it varies seasonally, right? So if you collect the sale of winter cloth per month, then you will get there is ups and downs according to the season, right? So these are the four components. Generally, we do not consider the irregular component and cyclical component. We basically, in the simple model, we try to understand what is the trend part. Right? You can write the model in additive form also. So YT is equal to RT, T plus C plus S plus I. This is the additive model of time series in general, but there is no guarantee that in all kinds of series you have the four component. If the data set is monthly, quarterly or weekly, sometimes we are interested to understand the seasonal variation. Then we try to understand what is the seasonal variation component under the time series data. So we do not enter this part also. We only study how do we smooth the data, that is how do we remove or at least reduce the fluctuation, short term fluctuation in the past values of the variable, past values of the time series. Okay,
so so four trends are secular, cyclical, seasonal and irregular.
Yes. Clear? These are the these are the common or general component of a time series. So we basically we deal here only the train component. We try to understand what is the nature of the train, analyzing the past values of the variable, and try to predict the future values in terms of the train. Right. So for smoothing and forecasting, first, so a class of deterministic model is called extrapolation model of extrapolation. That is the fitting of train. You can fit to understand the train. You can fit yt is equal to say c0 plus c1t. T is the time. It is 1, 2, 3, 4. If it is monthly data, then 1, 2, 3, 4. You attach 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. If it is yearly data, then t is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. So it is the trend. If you find the data set has a deterministic trend, yeah, upward rising trend, constant trend, upward rising or downward sloping, then you can formulate the linear trend, or you can formulate the cubic trend, that is c0 plus c1t plus c2t square, right? Or you can fit a autoregressive trend, that is yt is equal to c0 plus c1y t minus 1. All these things are the deterministic model of train. We do not analyze this part also. We actually concentrate in the moving average part. That is the main objective of this lecture. That is, we try to understand what are the moving average technique for forecasting and smoothing. Particularly, we consider the simple moving average and exponential smoothing, that is exponentially weighted moving average for smoothing and forecasting, right? So we study the moving average technique, and more specifically we study the exponentially weighted moving average technique for smoothing and forecasting. Smoothing means the just removing or reducing the fluctuation in the data set to understand the average trend, and smoothing is the reducing or removing the fluctuations, short term fluctuations over in the data set, and forecasting is the predicting the future values of the variable. This is the definition. So moving average means the moving of the average. I think you know what is average. Suppose if you have the data set y1, y2, dot, 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 y capital T. You can take 2, 3 years moving average. That is, you will add 3 years moving average means, then say, y t smooth. If you consider the moving average, so it is y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. It is the y1 tilde or y1 hat, y1 cap. 3 years moving average, right? It is called simple running moving average. So y2 is equal to y2 tilde is equal to y2 plus y3 plus y4 divided by 3, right? Okay. So now if you want to use this technique for forecasting, what will happen? So you have data up to capital T, right? So here y1 tilde is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. or you can consider, if you want to use the method for forecasting, then you will say y t plus 1 hat, because you have data up to t. If you want to know what is the t plus 1 period value of y, then you can write y t plus 1 cap. This is equal to simply y, it is not y t plus 1, because you don't know what is the actual value of y t plus 1. For forecasting, you will say it is y t plus y t minus 1 plus y t minus 2 by 3. Right? Is it clear or not?
Sir, last equation is not clear for me.
Y t plus 1, it is the predicted value or forecasting value, forecasted value. Y capital T plus one hat. These are the tilde, these are the smoothing actually. This is the definition of moving average, three period moving average. Okay? Three period moving average.
So T minus 1, T minus 2, that's mean?
That is, you have the data Y1, Y2, that is Y T up to Y T. So previous data is Y T minus 1, right? And before that, Y T minus 2, like that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
Clear?
Yes,
if you want to forecast, if you want to know what is the future value at time point capital T plus 1, if you use the three period moving average, then ultimately you will say the forecasted value is equal to last three periods, average of last three periods value.
স্যার এটা তো ওয়াই টি পিরিয়ডের মুভিং অ্যাভারেজ হয়ে গেল
ওয়াই টি পিরিয়ড না না ইট ইজ ওয়াই টি টি প্লাস 1 ইয়েস সো অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইন দ্য মুভিং অ্যাভারেজ টেকনিক উই ইউজ দ্য জাস্ট লাস্ট পিরিয়ড মুভিং অ্যাভারেজ অ্যাজ দ্য প্রেডিক্টেড ভ্যালু অফ দ্য ফিউচার ভ্যালু ইউ আর কারেক্ট ইন দ্যাট সেন্স It is nothing but the moving average of yt. That is, you can say it is nothing but y capital T tilde. Okay? You are correct. In the moving average technique, actually we use the last period moving average as a predicted value of one period ahead forecasted value. Okay? Is it clear or not? So moving average model is useful if we believe that the likely value, the predicted value for our series, that is next month, is the simple average of its values over the past three periods. Is it clear? So it is a very simple model. Just you consider the last moving average value as the predicted value for the next time point. Okay? Hello? So here 3, 5, 7, 12, it depends on the nature of data. If you have a data, say weekly data, right, then you can take four period moving average. If you have monthly data, then you can take a 12 month moving average, right? If you have yearly data, then you can take three period moving average or five period moving average. Is it clear or not? Please respond, otherwise it is very difficult to understand whether you are taking my points or not.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. So similarly, if you have the data, so in general, moving average is forecasted values of moving average. If you take the n period moving average, then yt plus 1 hat is equal to simply 1 by n yt plus yt minus 1 plus ... yt minus n minus 1, because 1, 2, 3, that is n minus n observations are there. Is it clear? This is a general formula for forecasting using simple moving average. Okay. So what is the drawback in this process? If you use the moving average for forecasting, then actually you take a small period for averaging the data. You did not consider the distant past values of the variable, right? That is why. And not only that, here we have considered the equal weightage for the observations under consideration. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now that is a to reduce this problem, that is the equal weightage problem, we just move on the more general moving average method, which is called exponentially weighted moving average. Right? What is the exponentially weighted moving average? Here we consider the all past values for forecasting. Here we consider all past values for forecasting. Right? If you have a large data point, that is a large sample, then exponentially weighted moving average for forecasting, exponentially weighted moving average is nothing but the so predicted value of y p plus 1 is equal to alpha into y t plus alpha into 1 minus alpha into y t minus 1 plus alpha into 1 minus alpha square y t minus 2 plus ... up to infinity. So forecasted value, that is one period ahead forecasted value, is not equal to the simple average of the past 3, 4, 5 or 12 values. It is the weighted average of the all values in your series. Is it weighted average? So why it is weighted average? It is weighted average because if you add the weights, so this is the weight of yt, this is the weight of yt minus 1, this is the weight of yt minus 2. If you add this weight after infinity, and if you get it is 1, then you can say it is weighted average. Is it clear or not? And why it is called exponentially weighted moving average? Because weights is falling exponentially or geometrically. I will prove it. So simply you can write forecast. So alpha is an ad hoc value, arbitrary value. It is the main problem of exponentially weighted moving average. You have to assume the value. What is the value of alpha? Generally, alpha greater than 0, less than 1. It is called parameter. That is moving average parameter, exponentially moving average parameter, which lies between 0, greater than 0, but less than 1. If it is 1, what is the mean? It means that you have put the greatest weightage with the recent past value and no weightage with the other values. Right? So if you want to give more weightage on the recent past values compared to the older values of the variable, then you choose alpha close to 1. Right? If you choose alpha close to 0, that is you are going to emphasize less on the current value and more on the past values. If you emphasize more on the past values, that is you are smoothing heavily the data set. That is, if you choose alpha close to 0, that is if you are giving less importance on the past values of the variable, recent past values of the variable, that is you are smoothing the series heavily. So, but still alpha is arbitrary. You have to choose according to your research objective, right? So there is no any way to estimate or determine the values of alpha. It is totally arbitrary. Now we want to prove why it is called moving average and it is exponentially weighted. So if you add the weights, suppose weights equal to W, total weights, sum of weights equal to alpha plus alpha into 1 minus alpha plus alpha into 1 minus alpha square plus dot dot dot, right? Suppose it is W. You have to prove W is equal to 1. Now if you take common alpha, so W is equal to alpha common, so it is 1 plus 1 minus alpha plus 1 minus alpha square plus dot dot dot. Suppose this component so W is equal to alpha into, say this is B, this is A, right? Again you can write it is alpha into 1 plus, if you take common 1 minus alpha from here, then you will get 1 plus 1 minus alpha plus 1 minus alpha square plus dot dot dot. Is it clear or not?
No sir, repeat please.
W is the sum of the weights. I have to prove W is equal to 1, right? So then it is alpha plus alpha into 1 minus alpha plus alpha into 1 minus alpha square dot 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 up to infinity. Now if you take alpha as common, so you will get 1 plus 1 minus alpha plus 1 minus alpha square. Is it clear or not? Suppose this part is equal to A, then W is equal to alpha into A. Again W is equal to alpha into 1 plus 1 plus 1 minus alpha 1 common, then 1 plus 1 minus alpha plus 1 minus alpha square, right? Hello?
Yes sir, yes.
Okay. So then W is equal to alpha into 1 plus 1 plus 1 minus alpha into, again it is equal to A. Right or wrong? Right? Then it is equal to alpha plus alpha into 1 minus alpha into A. Okay? It is nothing but alpha plus alpha into, 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha, alpha into A means again W, right? Okay? That is alpha plus 1 minus alpha into A, W. ওকে। ওকে, দেন ডব্লিউ then W is equal to alpha plus W minus alpha into W. Okay. Hello. So W is equal to alpha plus W into minus alpha into W. So therefore W cancel and alpha is equal to alpha W. So W is equal to 1, alpha by alpha. Is it clear or not? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So therefore, where sum of weight is equal to 1, that means it is nothing but average. First, it is clear that y t plus 1 hat is nothing but the average of the all values in your series. So therefore, one advantage of the exponentially weighted moving average is that it includes all the variable values in your series for forecasting. It is not considered only the 3, 5, or 7 values. And second point is weight is falling geometrically, that is exponential. What is the weight? Weight of yt is alpha and weight of yt minus 1 is alpha into 1 minus alpha. So if you take the ratio alpha into 1 minus alpha by alpha, it is 1 minus alpha. If you take the ratio of any two successive weights of the values, you will get it is 1 minus alpha. As 1 minus alpha is less than 1, so it weight is falling at a constant rate. That is why it is exponentially weighted moving. Why it is moving average? Because if you consider y t plus 1 hat, it is the one period ahead forecasted value, right? But if you want to forecast the future values, that is 2 period ahead, what is the 2 period ahead forecasted value? It is again alpha into y t plus 1 hat, because there is no available value for y t plus 1, then you have to use the forecasted value, right? You can write this thing actually alpha into summation I 1 to infinity 1 minus alpha to the power I into y t minus r. You can write this summation can be write in this specific form. Now if you consider 2 period ahead forecasted value, this is nothing but alpha into y t plus 1 hat plus alpha into 1 minus alpha y t, not t hat, y t hat, because it is available to you, plus dot 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 up to infinity. Then you will again find it is nothing but y t plus 1 hat. So in the method of exponentially weighted moving average, you cannot vary the forecasted value. Your one period ahead forecasted value is equal to 2 period ahead forecasted value, etc., etc. So it is constant. It is another disadvantage of this forecasting process, right? And the moving average method and the exponentially moving average methods are called actually adaptive method of forecasting. Why it is called adaptive? Because actually the forecasted values adjust themselves with the available values. Because if you put the values of y t plus 1 hat, then you will get it is nothing but the weighted average of your given values. So ultimately you will get y t plus 2 hat as a function of your existing values. That is why these two methods are called adaptive method of forecasting. Okay. Okay, I will apply this theory with the help of SPSS and Excel also. So now we move on the concept of smoothing. This is the method of forecasting. How do you use the moving average method and the exponentially weighted moving average method for forecasting, right? So here we actually do not use the method when the series has some deterministic trend, etc., etc. If you have some small data set and if you want to predict the future value for this small data set, which generally 10 to 30 observations, then you can use them. But actually they are very simple, but they are not accurate. Why? Because it depends on some personal bias, because you have to choose the values of alpha, right? And secondly, here we did not consider the stochastic component of time series, right? Now we come to the smoothing. This is more interesting compared to the forecasting with the help of moving average technique. Why do we smooth the data? Actually, from the smoothing series, we actually gauge the nature of data. So again, we use the two method for smoothing. We have already told you, if you want to smooth using the moving average method for n period moving average, running moving average, then it is 1 by n y t plus y t minus 1 plus dot 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 plus y t minus n plus 1. This is the smooth value of yt. Why do we smooth the value? Actually, we reduce the fluctuation in the data set. Try to reduce the fluctuation, and if you plot y1 smooth, y2 smooth, that dot 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 yt smooth, then you will actually guess the permanent feature of the series. Permanent feature of the series. Because if you just plot the real values, you will get there is some many ups and downs. It is very difficult to understand what is the permanent nature of the series, whether it is moving to the upward direction or it is reducing or etc. So to understand the permanent nature of the data, you have to smooth it with the help of running moving average. So here we consider only the past values. But if you consider the centered moving average method, then you will take some lag values and some lead values. Then there is a problem. You cannot get 2-3. If you take the 3 period moving average, then you cannot find out the first and last smooth value. So what is the definition? It is yt smooth. For n period, it is 1 by n. Suppose n is equal to 3, then it is y t plus 1 plus y t plus y t minus 1. This is the centered moving average, 1 by 3. If you take the 5 period centered moving average, because here moving average is not the simple average of the past values. It is the average of the past and future values corresponding to this particular observation. Okay, so if you take the 5 period centered moving average, then yt tilde is equal to 1 by 5 yt plus 2 yt plus 1 plus yt plus yt minus 1 plus yt minus 2, right? This is the centered moving average. This is the smooth value. Here my objective is to reduce the fluctuation, short term fluctuation in the data set to understand the true nature of the data set, right? Then you can use the smooth value for forecasting also. So actually, if you consider the exponentially smoothing technique for exponentially smoothing technique, then you have to use the weighted, exponentially weighted moving average, right? This is the moving average technique. Now, if you consider the exponentially moving average technique, then yt tilde is equal to alpha into yt plus alpha into same thing, that is 1 minus alpha into y t minus 1 plus alpha into 1 minus alpha square y t minus 2 plus dot dot dot. Right? It is the exponentially weighted moving average. Here we consider all values for smoothing the data. Right? Or you can write it is equal to alpha into yt plus, suppose you take common 1 minus alpha, then it is alpha into yt minus 1 plus alpha into 1 minus alpha yt minus 2 plus dot 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 infinity. You can write in that way. So what is it? It is the smooth value of yt minus 1. So ultimately you can write it is alpha into yt plus 1 minus alpha into yt tilde, t minus 1 tilde. This is the smooth value applying smoothing technique, exponentially smoothing technique. Here you if you consider the larger value of alpha, that is, you are putting more emphasis on the current value and you are you do not smooth heavily. But if you choose alpha close to 0, that is 0.1, 0.2, that is, you are smoothing heavily. That is, you are emphasizing more on the past values of the variable and less on the recent values of y. Higher the value of alpha, lower is the smooth of the series, right? Sometimes we are interested to smooth heavily, but we do not want to put more emphasis on the past values of the variable. Then what do we do? Then we smooth second time, which is called double smoothing. So if suppose it is your series, then double smoothing, that is yt double tilde is equal to alpha into yt tilde plus 1 minus alpha y t minus 1 tilde, double tilde. It is called double smoothing. So if you smooth following the exponentially smoothing technique, then generally if the series has upward rising trend, then ultimately you will underestimate the series. But if there is downward sloping trend, you will overestimate the series. We will check it from the data set. Right, that is why if there is a clear trend in the series, we should first estimate the trend of the equation, then you should go for exponential smoothing technique for smoothing. Then ultimately to get the final smoothing value, you have to add the trend part. You can estimate the trend applying the linear regression model or quadratic curve fitting model, etc., etc. So here, if you know there is some trend and you want to only try to smooth the series, then what do we do? Then we use the whole double parameter smoothing technique, right? Which adjusts the general values of the variable as well as the trend part of the variable. What is it? So hold. double parameter smoothing time. What is it? Here we not only smooth the general value of yt, we also smooth the trend, because to reduce the problem of overestimation or underestimation of the series if there is some trend. Okay, so then we use the two equation. One is the exponential smoothing part, another is the trend smoothing part. Then yt tilde is equal to alpha into yt plus 1 minus alpha into yt minus 1 tilde plus suppose lt minus 1. It is the change of long term trend, not minus, it is plus, sorry. Where lt is equal to, it is the smoothing part, lt is equal to say gamma into yt tilde minus yt minus 1 tilde plus 1 minus gamma into lt minus 1. It is the two parameter, your alpha and gamma. If there is some trend, if you find the situation from your initial analysis considering the simple exponential smoothing technique, if you find there is some underestimation and overestimation problem, then you can use the whole double parameter smoothing technique, which adjusts the long-term change of trend, and where we formulate the two equation. Yt smooth, this is the smoothing value, alpha and gamma two parameters, alpha for the smoothing parameter and gamma is the trend parameter, that is the change of the smooth value, where L is the lt, and this is lt minus, that is 1 to your lag of lt, and it is 1 to your lag of lt. So here you have to assume two parameters, and both alpha and gamma greater than 0, less than 1, greater than 0, less than 1. Again, smaller the value of alpha, higher the density of smoothing. Similarly, lower the value of gamma, higher the density of smoothing, higher the intensity of smoothing. Okay. Similarly, there are three parameter adjustment model developed by Holtz and Winters. We do not go to this part. This is basically used for seasonal adjustment. This is the trend adjustment, and third one is the seasonal adjustment. For that purpose, you have to use three equations. One for the general smoothing value, one for the trend, and third for the seasonal adjustment. We do not go to this part, right? Due to the lack of time. Okay, this is the theory behind the smoothing and forecasting. Is it clear? And if you use the double parameter smoothing technique for forecasting, then it is y say t plus 1 hat is equal to simply y t smooth value plus l t. If you want to forecast two period ahead, then it is again 2 into this. If it is 3, ultimately if it is k, then it is k into l. This is the forecasted value. If you want to forecast the values of the variable using the Holtz double parameter smoothing technique, then use this equation. This is the equation for forecasting. Okay, Jason got that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we show you the real data, right? How to smooth data and how to use the data for forecasting using the exponentially weighted moving average method, right? Particularly. right? Okay, you can download the data for Sensex, India Sensex, right? BSE Sensex. It is free. Is my screen visible? Hello?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now first I open the data set in Excel. Okay. This is the data set from 2nd August 2021 to 26th November 2021. Okay, it is very current data. You can download it from website. It is available free for analysis. It is the Sensex data, BSE Sensex data, right? So first, before going to time series analysis, you should plot the data, right? Simply, if you consider both, actually there are three data. One is data at the time of opening the BSE, and then highest value, lowest value, and these are the closing time data, right? So if you plot the data, insert, this is the observation time series, that is over time, first increasing and then decreasing. So there is an uprising trend at the initial stage, then it is falling. It is a real life data. You have to smooth the data to understand the permanent nature of the data set, right? Then you can use the data set for forecasting. Okay, is it clear or not? So there are 80 data point, right? You can increase the data set, no problem, but first we smooth the data in Excel. So if you simply calculate moving average of 5 days, right? So it is a working days data, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So therefore it is better to take 5 period moving average. First we consider the running moving average for smoothing the data. What is it? Is equal to average average 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Okay. This is the moving average value, smooth value, considering the 5 period moving average. Now, if you plot close and moving average, that is original data and your smooth data, what is the picture? Again, insert, line diagram. So here you find that, so your smooth data actually captures the main features of the data set, but when it is falling, it is under, actually smooth data actually underestimate the original value. When it is increasing, then it is overestimate the original data, because there is some uprising trend. You can fit the trend also. This is the smoothing, right? Orange color line tells you the smooth values. Is it clear or not, participants?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But if you consider the centered moving average, same 5 period centered moving average, MA, C5, then you cannot get first two values. So then you start from third observation is equal to average of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Okay. Again, you remove last two values. This is the centered moving average value. You can use this also, right? Then check it. Insert. Okay. So blue line shows the original values of the variable and orange line shows the running moving average of 5 period and the gray color line shows you the centered moving average values, right? So compared to the running moving average, you find that your centered moving average is more appropriate compared to the running moving average because your smooth value are close to the original values when there is a falling tendency, right? And it is also close to the original values when the series is moving positively, right? Upward, in case of upward trend, there is a closeness between the centered moving average. So centered moving average more appropriate compared to the running moving average. Is it clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you consider the simple exponential smoothing technique. Simple exponential smoothing technique. What is it? So for the first value, it is the original value. Copy and paste here. Okay. Then suppose alpha is equal to 0.2. Okay. Then if alpha is equal to 0.2, then your smooth value for the second period is equal to 0.2 into yt, that is this one, plus 0.8 1 minus alpha into the past smooth value. Suppose it is here e2. So this is the smooth value applying the exponential smoothing technique. Is it clear? But these are not relevant. Now you plot original to moving average and last one is the exponential smoothing average. Insert this one. So among these three techniques, we find that centered moving average is most appropriate, right? And we find that compared to the moving average, exponentially moving average technique, that is exponential technique, is is less efficient because it maintains distance from the actual values. At least when it is actual series is increasing, then smooth value actually underestimate the actual values. When it is falling,
sir, it may happen that you have taken a wrong alpha.
Yes, you can take it. Tell me what is your.
I'm telling that it can be due to is alpha.
Yes. Suppose it is 0.8, what will happen? Check it. This is the modified series, I think. Okay. That means you have taken alpha is equal to 0.8. That means you try to emphasize more on the current values. So you are smoothing less heavily. Then it is close to the original values. Okay. You are right. But still, from here, I can say you, your centered moving average more appropriate. Is it clear or not?
Yes. Why?
That is the question. Because there is some trend in the series and seasonal fluctuation. So simple smoothing technique, simple exponential smoothing technique is not appropriate here. Because there is some seasonal variation and there is some trend. Okay. This is the main reason. If you consider just equal to 1, then you will find the just smooth value is equal to the past value, original value, right? You can do it, but it is not the true process for using the technique for forecasting, right? If you want to smooth heavily, you should choose lower value of alpha. Make sense or not? Okay. Now, if you want to compute the Holt's method, the two parameter method, what is it actually? You have to estimate three things. Suppose it is LT. LT. Suppose it is YT smooth, right? SYT, and this is LT, and this is YT plus 1. Okay, we have to estimate two series. One is the smooth value of YT and one is LT, capital LT. Right? So first you write your smooth value is the original value. So it is your original value. Copy, paste. What is LT? LT is nothing but the change of the smooth value, right? So it is equal to this one.
So you have taken the closing value.
This one.
Yes.
Right. You have to take it.
Yes.
Actually, at the initial stage, it is different issue. It is the simple smoothing average, right? It is the simple exponential smoothing values, and it is the smoothing values with adjustment of trend. That is why I have started with the original values. So in that case, first two values, are the original values. SOIT means the original values, right? And here you have to take two original values for smoothing. Why? Because there are two parameters, so you have to take initial two values as given. Okay. Then LT is equal to this one minus, these are the smooth values as well as the original values. Right, and YT is equal to, I come to the part later on. Now we compute LT, smoothing values. What is it? Can you tell me the equation? That is alpha, suppose alpha is equal to 0.2. 0.2 into 0.2 into YT, that is YT, is equal to 0.2 into YT, that is this one, plus 0.8 into LT minus 1. Smooth value, that is. Can you tell me the equation? This one plus this one. Okay. And for LT, it is beta is equal to beta. Suppose beta is equal to 0.3. So 0.3. into bracket start LT minus, YT tilde minus YT tilde minus 1, right? So this one minus this one plus 0.7 into T minus 1, that is LT minus T minus 1. Okay, now your forecasted value, because these two are the original values, so we do not consider them for forecasting. Forecasted value is simply this one, that is one pure forecasted value is equal to plus this one. Now we try to plot the original values with the whole smooth value, right? Only these two. Insert this one. Again, there is some problem. That means there is some seasonal variation. You have to adjust this thing also, right? So we will use SPSS for forecasting and for smoothing, right? Now open SPSS. Is it clear or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now for importing the data, I will delete all this. File, open, data, right? Then open data. Excel file from desktop. This one. Open. And sheet 4. Okay, this is your data set. First, you have to define the dates, right? Because it is a daily data, right? Or you can say weekly data, 5 days weekly data. So data, click on data, then define data, then weeks, work days 5, right? Okay, so it is adjusted. That is, first week, first day, first week, second day, first week, fifth day, second week, first day, like that. So now, if you want to smooth data, only applying moving average, then you can transform. Click on transform, then create time series. Here only you have the option, moving average, right? It is prior moving average, running centered moving average only is available here, right? Then okay. What's a different situation? Create time series, close. Close. Centered moving average, change, right? Then okay. Then check it. This is the moving average values. Close one. Check it. What was the span? Transform. One foot moving average right there. So take it 5, right? Then change. Okay. This is the 5-period moving average. So first two observations absent here because it has taken centered moving average, right? If you want to plot them in the Excel SPSS field, then simply analyze what from here sequence chart, right? Then close variable and MA, right? Okay, this is the plot of the original values indicated by the blue line and moving average indicated by the green line. Is it clear? This is the plot of the true values and the smooth value, right? But in SPSS you cannot do it using exponentially smoothing technique, but you can use the exponentially smoothing technique for forecasting. I will come to that part. So now analyze forecasting, create model. Suppose you want to forecast the future value, one pure future value, applying exponentially smoothing technique, right? Then create chart.
Sir, is step time ek baar dekhabein?
Yes. So just analyze, then forecasting. Okay. Then create model. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Then close. Expert model, rather you select exponential smoothing because we don't know what is ARIMA. ARIMA is the stochastic time series model. So then criteria, right? First you consider the simple exponential smoothing criteria. Then we check the holds and Winters technique, and there is no change for the dependent variable transformation. So we will continue. For statistics, you can consider R square. Here actually SPSS estimate the value of alpha on the basis of the minimization of the root mean squared error. It is not a good technique, but here from the observed data and the smooth data, they have computed the error, then minimize the sum of square of errors. That is why they actually estimate the value of alpha, and it is close to 1 to actually minimize the error. That is the point. That is why you have said that you are telling that you should consider 0.8, 0.9, that if you take 1, then it is definitely equal to the past value. Right. Ultimately, SPSS consider alpha is equal to 1. I will check it. Parameter estimate. Right. Then option. I want to forecast for 1 week. Say 1 week and 5 days. Right. Then okay. You will get the result. What is it? Check it. So this is the actual values and this is the predicted values. We have theoretically proved that the predicted value, that is y hat t plus 1 is equal to y hat t plus 2 dot dot dot. So that is why it is fixed in case of simple exponential method of forecasting. Is it clear? And alpha value is equal to 1. That is, in this process, most important point is that here we emphasize more on the very recent values of the variable. That is why it is equal to 1. Alpha is equal to 1. Right? This is the predicted value. Now we check what will happen if you consider the whole two parameter estimation. Okay? So it is expected that after coming 5 days, it will be equal to simply less than 58,000. Sensex value is less than 58,000. It is expected. But actually, all these forecasting are ad hoc actually. There is no any precision, and these are not the accurate forecasting process because they did not consider the randomness, that is a stochastic part of the time series. So it is very simple, but actually it gives you a rough idea about the future values of the variable. Now we come to the point, if you consider to adjust the trend, what will happen? Criteria, here we consider holds linear trend. Right, then continue and okay, what will happen? So here alpha and gamma 1 and 0.97. But for smoothing the trend is highly heavily smooth, right? But the common value, that is the average value, is not smooth at all, then you find that it is expected that in the coming week, values of the Sensex will fall steadily, right? But still there is some error, because from our analysis under the Excel field, we have found that there is a discrepancy between the actual values and the predicted values, smooth values, if you consider the whole method. Therefore, we should consider the seasonal factors, and you have to adjust the seasonal factors. For that purpose, you will consider forecasting, create model, and select criteria. Then you select winters multiplicative. That is, we have considered the YT is the product of trend, seasonal fluctuation, cyclical fluctuation, and irregular part. Then if you and current periodicity is 5, because it's a 5 days week, five days week, then continue and okay. Then what will happen? Again, it shows that there is a falling tendency, but it is not steady fall. Fall and then rise, then fall. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Does some good there?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
7 o'clock.
Yes.
Sir. Hello, sir.